Welcome back to Chemistry Matters. At this point of our unit on matter, we're now ready to look at mixtures. In our candy example from the last video, this bowl of candy represented the atmosphere of the Earth: nitrogen, oxygen, argon, and carbon dioxide. And as you can see, they all maintain their individual chemical properties. This was very important to Felix Baumgartner. He became famous in 2012 when he performed the highest free fall ever, starting 24 miles above the Earth and falling at a rate of more than 800 miles per hour. In order to do that and survive to tell about it, he had to have a very good understanding of chemistry and mixtures. As part of this course, you'll need to learn more about the characteristics of mixtures and how they can be separated. So let's get back to our classroom to learn more about why chemistry and mixtures were so important to Felix.
While he was skydiving back to Earth, one of the most prominent sounds that Felix Baumgartner heard was his own breathing. His air tank had to have the right mixture of gas in order for him to survive the jump, especially traveling at the speeds he was traveling at. Some materials in his suit were a mixture of chemicals. These mixtures had to be able to withstand extreme temperatures and extreme pressures. Most of the matter you use in everyday life is composed of mixtures. But my question to you is, what exactly is a mixture?
It's a combination of different materials.
Yes, but more specifically, a mixture is a combination of two or more pure substances in which each pure substance retains its individual chemical properties. A pure substance is made up of just one chemical, either an element alone or a group of elements chemically bonded to each other. Interestingly enough, everyday matter is composed mostly of mixtures. Substances tend to mix naturally. It's extremely difficult to keep any single substance pure. Now let's think about some of the mixtures you see in everyday life. Any ideas?
Ice cream's a mixture.
Okay, but how do you know ice cream is a mixture?
Because we make it at home sometimes. It's a frozen mixture of milk and sugar and some peaches or strawberries.
You're right. Anyone else?
Isn't pencil lead a mixture?
Yes, the material we call lead in our pencils is actually a material called graphite, made of carbon atoms held together with a binder like clay. Any other examples?
I play percussion, and I've heard that the cymbals I use are made of a mixture of copper and tin.
You're right. Cymbals are usually made up of copper and tin, but it's important to understand that to make the cymbals, melted copper and tin were poured together to form the mixture, but they did not chemically react with each other. And these metals can be separated by heating them, with the tin melting at a much lower temperature than the copper. You see, all mixtures can be classified as either homogeneous or heterogeneous. A homogeneous mixture is a combination of two or more substances that have uniform composition and chemical properties throughout. Homogeneous mixtures are also called solutions. A heterogeneous mixture is a combination of two or more substances in which the original substances are separated into physically distinct regions with different properties. I've got some Italian salad dressing here. Let me shake it up. Can you tell if it's homogeneous or heterogeneous?
Italian dressing can't be homogeneous. It's got oil and all those chunks of spices in it, and vinegar too. You always have to shake it up when you take it out of the refrigerator, and it never really mixes completely.
Great observation. Now I'm going to dissolve this salt into this beaker of water. Can you tell if this is a heterogeneous or a homogeneous mixture?
The salt water is homogeneous. You can tell because the salt and the water mixed together, and now you can't see the white salt anymore. It's all clear.
And it stayed mixed.
You're right. Now, let's go back to that ice cream that you mentioned earlier. Unfortunately, I don't have any on hand, but I've got this picture. You said you put peaches and strawberries in your ice cream. So is that homogeneous or heterogeneous?
That must be a heterogeneous mixture. While it's mixed together, the fruit would not be fully blended into it.
Right. What about that drum cymbal you mentioned?
The cymbal is a homogeneous mixture.
Correct. Well, how do you know that?
The whole cymbal looks like one single type of metal. You can't really see the different parts in it.
I agree. Good job.
As you can see, mixtures are not all built the same way, so we would expect them to behave differently. The cross-cutting concept we're observing here is called structure and function. The way a mixture is built on the chemical level affects how it behaves and how we use the mixture in everyday life. For example, when Felix Baumgartner was planning his jump, mixtures were very important. He had to utilize mixtures of materials with a structure that met the requirements for an airtight, flexible, heat-resistant suit. If intermolecular forces were too strong, the suit would not be flexible. But if intermolecular forces were too weak, the suit could not be heat-resistant and airtight. His suit had to be designed with the right mixture of materials. That allowed the atmosphere inside his suit, which was a mixture of gases designed to keep him comfortable, to stay inside his suit. And of course, he made the jump through the atmosphere, which again, is a mixture of gases. Now we're going to find out about solutions, which is another name for homogeneous mixtures. Now be careful. Most people think solutions are all liquids, like these. We have blue food coloring dissolving into water, sugar dissolving into water, and seawater, a mixture of water and several kinds of salts. But solutions can also be solids, liquids, and gases mixed in various combinations. So let's go back to our class and see some examples of these solutions.
Can anyone give me an example of a gas-gas solution?
Sure, air.
Good. There are also gas-liquid solutions. Where have we seen those?
Like soda? If you shake it up, all the bubbles come shooting out the top.
Soda contains carbon dioxide dissolved under pressure. We call those drinks carbonated. What's an example of a solid liquid solution?
Salt water?
Exactly. So what's left?
Solid-solid mixtures, like the symbols.
Right. Another example is the Liberty Bell in Philadelphia. It's made mostly of copper, tin, but also lead, zinc, arsenic, and gold, and silver. A mixture like that is called an alloy. We see alloys all the time. Generally, alloys are a homogeneous mixture of metals, or a mixture of a metal and a nonmetal in which the metal is the major component. Steel can be a mixture of iron and carbon. Adding the carbon atoms increases its hardness. Manufacturers combine properties of various metals into an alloy to achieve greater strength and durability. Car companies such as Tesla have to use alloys in order to build a strong car that can survive a crash impact while reducing the weight of the vehicle. Can anyone think of another way alloys are used?
How about alloy wheels?
Great. Alloy wheels lower the weight of the car by mixing metals to form the strongest low-weight combination possible. Does anyone else have any other examples?
What about 24-karat gold? Doesn't the carat part mean that there are other things in it?
Right. The carat refers to the amount of copper, silver, or platinum that's mixed in.
Wait, I don't understand. Why would you mix other metals with gold? Gold is an element, which is pure, right? Why does it need to be mixed with anything else?
Great question. Pure gold is too soft to maintain its shape easily. The additional metals make it more rigid. Otherwise, a pure gold ring or bracelet would quickly become damaged or deformed.
The students in our classroom have learned a lot about physical and chemical properties of matter, chemical and physical changes, as well as how materials can be mixed together to form different kinds of solutions. Of course, separating materials can be just as important as putting them together. So we'll take a look at that in the next video on the playlist. See you there!